Get ready to match the stars. Dick Morton, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dee Dee Kahn, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded big money match game 76. And now here's the star of match game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Are you ready? Follow me. Over here, we have six people who work cheap. No, I'm only kidding. This is really a marvelous bunch. We've been having a good time all this week. I've really enjoyed it, and I expect to have a few more laughs today. Are you all ready to begin?
Uh-huh.
All right. Let's say hello to our two players. Oh, I'm sorry. In case you weren't with us earlier this week, this new face to you, this first week she's been on this show, is in a TV show called The Practice. Dee Dee Kahn, welcome.
Thank you.
I did the kissing and all that, so once is not enough. But now, keep it going for Gloria Cachet and Ken McCarthy. Welcome to two of you. Hi. Gloria's the current champ. She won one game. She doesn't have much money, but she's hopeful.
You bet.
And Ken McCarthy is going to challenge her now. It's the first time we've met him.
Okay.
And we welcome him and wish him the best of luck and ask him to tell us the story of his life.
Well, I'm originally from Long Island, New York. I'm presently residing in Northridge, and I'm an L.A. city fireman.
Uh-huh. There it is. Dangerous work.
Yeah, a lot of times.
Well, my hat's off to you and all firemen. You guys risk your lives. You do a marvelous job. And we'll start this game in a moment or so, Ken. But we've got to do a little business with America, and then we'll get right back to you. So hurry back. Two. Hello there. Dean. First round, Ken, you have a choice, A or B.
B.
B it is, for McCarthy. Now.
B for McCarthy.
I don't talk plain. Nancy said to the psychiatrist, "You see, doctor, my husband packs up leftovers and gives them to customers. What's so strange is that he doesn't work in a restaurant. He works in a blank." You see, doctor,
I think I like that.
"My husband packs up leftovers and gives them to customers. What's so strange is that he doesn't work in a restaurant. He works in a blank."
I've got a wonderful answer. I wonder if it makes sense.
I've got one. I'm sorry, I'm not playing there.
Oh, we're sorry.
That's a good one.
Was that yours?
That's a good one. Yes, very good. Okay, these people are ready. Nick, you're ready.
See how quickly I am.
Yes, are you still good?
No. He's not slow like Charles. He's dumb. He's fat.
Oh, yes. Are you still keeping score?
Oh, yes.
Out of a
look
possible
at all those zeros.
Four on the first day, there were four zeros. Back. Out of a possible three...
I'm trying to think of an answer. Couldn't this go on the late news?
Oh, I'm sorry, Captain. I'm only a first mate.
Your powers of concentration are limited, aren't they?
Well, wouldn't yours be?
I see. Okay. He's writing something, and I guess he's got an answer. Ken, Nancy said to the psychiatrist, she said, "You see, doctor, my husband packs up leftovers and gives them to customers. What's so strange is that he doesn't work in a restaurant. He works in a blank."
Massage parlor?
Massage parlor? Not Ken. 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 Listen, you don't understand this question. Don't answer so quickly next time, because your answer makes no sense, Ken.
Okay.
He works in a massage parlor. All right. I'll give you $1,000 on the side if somebody says massage parlor.
I'll be the closest, because I said laundry.
In the laundry. What's the strange? He doesn't wear an arrest. He worked in a laundry. All right, there's another zero for him there.
Oh, wait a minute. I have to write that down.
All right.
Zero?
Yeah.
Another zero.
Okay.
Where's my $1,000? No.
Ah, you rascal.
No, to think I was worried about mine not making sense. I said mortuary.
Mortuary is very good. Packs up leftovers and gives them to customers, you see, Charles?
Mortuary.
Mortuary. All right.
What's so strange is that he doesn't work in a restaurant. He works in a massage parlor. You know, if the question were different, it might not be a bad answer.
Yeah, I thought about the massage parlor dropouts at the morgue.
At the morgue, yeah. Okay, morgue is good.
I don't know what would be left over there, but I deal with a guy who brings some very nice leftovers. He's in a hospital.
In the hospital. Packs up the leftovers and gives them to the...
I had some cold cuts from the other day.
You did? Oh, dear. Let's move along here.
Okay, I said plastic surgeon's office.
That's good, too.
Oh, that's a good
very
answer,
neat.
Please, yeah.
Okay. Ken, you getting the hang of it now?
Yeah, I got it.
That's just kind of a little warm-up question. Now, here's your little warm-up question. Here we go. Richard Dawson said...
An accent again.
Richard... Richard Dawson said, this last night... I saw a note written on my dressing room wall that said... No, he said, last night I saw a note written on my dressing room wall that said, for a good time, call 555-2379. Well, I called the number, and was I disappointed? Blank answered. Listen, this number... Did you check this out? This is a zero number as far as I tell. Okay, good, because... I just warn anybody who may be listening, do not call a number because you will get nothing. It's some special number you get from the phone company. Good to have a little bit. I just pointed a blank answer. Okay. What do you say, Brett?
Oh, honey, I'm ready. By the time you get there, don't worry.
I will walk over
to
Gloria Cachet. Richard Dawson said, last night I saw a note written on my dressing room wall that said, for a good time, call 555-2379. Well, I called the number and was I disappointed? Blank answered.
Information?
What did you put?
Two of a kind. Oh, dear me. Dick,
I was close.
They're making you look good, Dick.
I was close. I said Paul Lynde.
Paul Lynde.
The
phantom strikes again. What is?
It's sometimes it's so cute, isn't
he's
it?
He's cute, yes. I don't care. You don't get none right.
I was close too. This man had been proselytizing earlier in the evening. It was the president of Gay Lib.
Okay. Hello, Charles.
Hi, Charles.
He told me Nixon answered.
Nixon answered. Good time call his number, and was I disappointed? Okay. Now we come to you, Dee Dee.
My mother.
My mother.
No, his mother.
His mother. When I called, my mother answered. Now, Richard, what's the inside story on this? You were there.
I am not a crook.
All right, Patty?
I said a lonely private citizen Nixon.
A lonely private citizen Nixon. Isn't that interesting? That came up three times. It hadn't crossed my mind at all. So there we are, folks. Yeah. Nothing's happening here, but something's happening out there in television land, and this is it. And holding. Hello there. Round two coming up. Bing. There it is. A or B, Ken McCarthy.
I'll try A this time.
You'll try A this time. Got burned with B. B for burn. Listen to this now, Ken. Henry said, he says, I think that acupuncture specialist is a quack. Instead of delicately placing tiny needles in my body, he stood me up against the wall and threw blanks at me. Okay, here we go. Henry said, I think that acupuncture specialist is a quack. Instead of delicately placing tiny needles in my body, he stood me up against the wall and threw blanks at me.
Knives.
Knives. You don't like knives? They're against you, Ken. Knives is one possibility. There may be something a little bit better. Dick, show them.
Yes. Would you quickly mark down another zero?
Oh.
His golf shoes.
His golf shoes?
That's one step lower, Ken.
Funny.
Yes.
I said darts.
Darts is just... That's the definitive answer. All right, Charles.
I said darts, too. I'm sorry.
Darts. No, darts is a very good answer, Charles. Don't be sorry.
Well, I'm sorry for Ken.
Yes, you did your part. Now, Didi Khan?
I said swords.
Swords.
That's a big knife.
Sure it is. Try and talk him into it.
I'm sorry, Ken.
No. Richard?
I said darts.
Darts, there. Okay. Now, it's unlikely. No! It's possible, Ken, that Ms. Weirdo here down at the end would say knives.
Steak knives?
Ah! Ken? I was only kidding, Ken. I mean, that's such a rotten answer. I didn't expect anybody to say it, not even her.
Thank you.
Okay. That's one for him. Now, you need one to tie, two to win.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's easy for you.
Give it over to me.
Oh, no, it's easy.
Give it.
When Grog the caveman invented eyeglasses, he put them on and discovered that his wife was not a cavewoman. For 12 years, Grog had been sleeping with a blank. Grog the caveman invented eyeglasses. He put them on and discovered that his wife was not a cave woman. For 12 years, Grog had been sleeping with a blank.
And loving every minute of it.
Yes. You finish. Good. Go do it. I'll tell you when the show ends, tell them. All right?
You know, Ken is a fireman, and the fire department in New York was very nice when the play was there.
They were?
Which was the 9th Battalion, 4th Engine, 5th Division, Lieutenant Moriarty on the southwest corner of 48th and 8th Avenue, because they didn't make any siren noises when they passed the theater until they were out of the thing.
Isn't
That'll
that
be
nice.
Out for Christmas in hardcover.
9 buildings were burned down, but they
didn't have a
siren on.
Okay, Gloria, here we go. 1 to tie, 2 to win. When Grog the caveman invented eyeglasses, he put them on and discovered that his wife was not a cavewoman. For 12 years, Grog had been sleeping with a blank.
With a guy.
With a cave, another caveman, right? Another guy. What would you say? Oh, a dinosaur. They would say a dinosaur. Dick, what would you say?
I said brontosaurus.
A brontosaurus. Very good. He says brontosaurus. What do you say, Brett?
It don't match, do it?
No, it don't. You
the trick is to match.
A caveman. There it is. One for Gloria. That's a tie score. One more caveman will win the game.
Cave sailor.
Cave sailor. That wins the game for Gloria to say. What do the rest of you have? Okay. Here we go. All right, you hang around over here. We'll get back to you in a moment or so. But right now, we've got to say goodbye to Ken McCarthy. It was a very quick trip up here, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Ken, we're going to have some gifts for you. I'm glad you enjoyed it. A lot of gifts will be coming your way. Thank you very much, Ken McCarthy. And while we're spinning him off, we're going to spin a few messages exactly for you.
Morning to Brett.
Here we are. Gloria Cachet has won her second game. She now has $200. She didn't do well with the big money super match last time, but she's hoping to do better this time, right?
I sure am.
All right, here we go, Gloria. We pulled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Beauty blank. Remember, it's $500 if you match the most popular answer that audience gave. $250 for their second most popular answer, and $100 for the third most popular answer. And let's see what kind of answers we'll get from our celebrities.
I'm going to try my three standards, Richard.
Beauty and the Beast.
Beauty and the Beast is one.
Charles.
Beauty Mark.
Beauty Mark. Charles, that won't come off.
Don't.
So I'm stuck with a beauty mark. Is that so bad?
It don't make you beautiful.
Well.
But we love you anyway,
better
Charles.
Better than the Beast.
Okay, Brett.
What about Beauty Contest?
Beauty Contest. There they are. Beauty Contest, Beauty Mark, Beauty and the Beast. Now, you can have one of those, or something else might have crossed your mind which you think is better.
I like beauty contests.
Okay, beauty contest it is. It's the one that Brett gave you. Let's find out if it's up there and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Beauty contest, right off the bat. There it is. Congratulations to you. What's under the $250 one, Earl? Beauty shop. No, we didn't even say that. All right, what do you think, audience?
Beast.
All right. Earl, show us your beast. Oh, I did. That's the second time she's done it to you, Richard.
Snow skin off my nose.
She don't trust you, yes. Okay, now you've got $100 more. You're up to $300. Gonna play for 10 times 100 or 1,000 now. And which one will you try to match?
I am gonna try Richard.
I think you'll enjoy me. I'll give you a good show anyway. Let me put it that way.
Ready?
Yes.
You face me. Here it is, worth $1,000. And get your ESP going to Richard. Center blank. That's S. That's C E N T E R. Center blank. C E N T E R. He's made up his mind. Have you made up your mind, Gloria?
Yes, I have.
What do you say to that? Center blank.
Center stage.
Center stage. That's where we are right now. All right, Richard, for $1,000, she says center stage will match you.
I guess my mind was somewhere else. Center fold.
Center fold. Well, Gloria, you're doing it the hard way.
Sure.
Won two games, you got $300 here. But you got another shot at it now as we welcome Ida Smith. Here she comes. Hi. Okay, now you can climb aboard. You two ladies know each other?
Yes. Hi.
And we welcome Ida Smith and ask her to tell us a little bit about herself, please.
Well, I'm a secretary in my husband's office, and I play backgammon backstage and was lucky at it.
You like backgammon?
Yeah.
Good game.
Yeah.
Yes. We have some players around here. All right. Where do you live,
Ida? I live in Canoga Park.
Okay. Welcome and good luck, and here we go. Round one is your choice, A or B?
A.
A it is. Here we go. Let's see what it says here.
Okay.
Jacques Cousteau said...
Ah! Another actor.
You know what she said, I will tell you. My wife, she play mean trick on me. Oh, before I jump into the water, she put a blank in my wetsuit. What? Jacques Cousteau said, my wife, she play mean trick on me. Before I jump into the water, she put a blank in my wetsuit. Number first round questions, Ida, or can run far afield. And there are a number of good possibilities here.
There are?
Yeah.
Sure.
Before I jump into the water, she put a blank in my wetsuit.
Well, I suppose there are lots of answers for that, aren't there?
There are many answers for that.
I wish I could think of just one.
Well, look around you. You'll think of one. All right. Okay, let's go over here to Ida Smith. Everybody ready? Jacques Cousteau said, my wife, she play mean trick on me. Before I jump into the water, she put a blank in my wetsuit.
A frog.
A frog is a good answer. She put la grenouille. That's the way you say frog in French. La grenouille.
Provencière.
Oui.
I said fish.
A fish. A fish is not a frog.
No, not in
what do you say to this? That's another wrong answer for him.
I said that she was, it was not so terrible as it was interesting. She put a blonde.
A blonde in my wetsuit.
That's a blonde frog.
Oh, yeah. Well, monsieur.
Women, I have to see Charles's beauty mark.
But hello.
Being a man of the sea, as you can see from the T-shirt and from the hat,
yes.
I put the answer, which would be the most horrible thing to happen to someone in the wet.
What is that,
in
monsieur?
The suit, the wet. I put a big hole.
A big hole. Mon dieu, mon capitaine. What do you say, put a blank in my wetsuit?
A crab.
A crab.
Oh. A crab with a dash of lobster.
Crab and lobster. Oh, that would hurt very much.
Going.
What do you say, redhead lady?
I said le ice cube.
Le ice cube. In the right place, it wouldn't be too bad, I think. So, Ida, that is nothing for you. And now we have something for you.
We have no time to say goodbye.